So Big Brother has started to play housemates at their own game by changing the rules. Let's find out how that's messing with their minds with super psych Dr Rob Yeung, everybody. Hello, sir. Hello. Big news. Halfwit and Marcus are up, man. How's that going to affect them?
Well, I don't think it'll come as a surprise because with their rule breaking, you know, it was the kind of natural...
It was inevitable, yeah. Right? They've done it to themselves.
I think so. I think perhaps Sivash was also up, but the fact that he was repentant for his rule breaking, right, that just tipped it over the edge.
And he's a bit more agreeable as well, wouldn't you say, old Sivash?
Well, you know, he went back to the other housemates and apologised and said, you know, yeah, I'm really sorry for what I did. Whereas Marcus, completely unrepentant, said, you know, I've done nothing wrong.
Yeah.
Really
Marcus
riles.
And Halfwit are both nightmares, really, so, you know, it's not a massive surprise. Do you think they're the right two to be up this week?
Halfwit, definitely. I feel a bit bad in the first half, said I didn't like him. It's not that. I just think he's been asking for it. He's just been doing this all through the show.
Right, 2 minutes.
Marcus, bit of character, you know, probably less likely to be evicted, but I think it's a fair trial.
Right, OK. Dr Rob, it took them 6 weeks to get the luxury budget, and then because of those three, they got it all dragged away from them. I mean, how kind of infuriating is that going to be for the rest of the housemates?
Well, I think beforehand there was one clear group, so Sivash, Marcus and Halfwit were one group, and the rest of the housemates were just a collection of individuals. They weren't a unified group. But now that they've been punished, they clearly see that this little pack of people need to be, you know, kicked out. So, so they've now been unified. They have a cause. And even though they're not the most outspoken people in the house, they have strength in numbers now.
Right, OK, so maybe it's been a positive thing for the house, really.
I think for them, it's bringing them together. Yeah. You know, there are hate figures.
Because it's much better if there's, you know, a bit of a unit there rather than, you know, 10 individuals, for me, anyway. Now, they've changed the rules for the first time ever on Big Brother. They can talk about nominations. We've got some exclusive footage for you right now. Have a look at this.
Now that we're allowed to talk about it, Freddie, my man, I nominated you the first week. I'm sorry, yep.
Okay, fair enough. I nominated you that one time, but you knew. Do you remember you had that really bad argument with us?
That's the only thing I've ever said about.
Every time you upset me, I never nominated you.
I just want to say, I'm not discussing nomination. I'm not discussing because I have my principles, you know?
You nominated me, B?
Yeah.
I nominated you, actually, because I knew you'd nominate me.
But Dr. Rob, how's that twist going to affect the house? Because that's got to be a weird one, going up to everybody and going, you know what, I've got to be honest, I know we've been pretending we've been friends for the last 3 weeks, but I've nominated you 3 times or whatever.
Well, I think it's interesting because it depends on where they lie on their personality trait. It's something called conscientiousness. So people like Rodrigo are very high on conscientiousness. So he's someone who likes to play by the rules, he's a good citizen, does what he's told. So actually, you know,
he's not getting involved, he's saying, anyway.
Well, this is basically pulling the rug underneath his feet. So they're saying, you know, the rules have all changed, and he's just not being able to cope very well. Whereas people like Marcus, very low on conscientiousness, likes to be a maverick, and this suits, it's playing to him, actually.
But isn't this going to dig up, you know, because obviously, you know, there are, you know, it seems that people are friends and then they're not friends, and isn't this going to kind of dig up bad blood from the past?
Well, I think it depends how you've been playing the game so far. So it's very important to be consistent. So again, you know, to bring in psychological jargon, but, you know, people should be authentic.
Yeah.
So depending on what your values are, you should behave in line with how you have previously been behaving. So if you've not been bitching and, you know, sort of backstabbing, then don't get involved now. So you don't need to show all of your cards.
Right.
Whereas if you have been playing all those political games,
yeah,
then now's the time to explain your actions.
This is politics. Basically, if you're big enough, then your friends will sometimes not vote for you. And it's a big test of Fred how he responds to this. If you're not big, then you're going to get really hurt. But those people will probably get to the sidelines. So, you know, you've got this rebel yell, this insurrection. The community's pushing against it. And that's, I think, what this eviction's all about.
All right, guys. Lovely. Thank you very much. Let's get Ravi in, guys. Give him a big round of applause. Now, Ravi, sit yourself down. That was for them, Ravi. That was for them, not for you. And now, last night, we saw all sorts of interesting stuff go on. And now today, your boy's up, Ravi. What a nightmare.
Yeah,
is he going to be able to get through it?
I hope so. I mean, Fred responds well to adversity. I think this is the biggest test he's had so far. I hope he pulls through. I hope he pulls his character together.
I've got to be honest with you. I've seen a bit of a change in him in the last little while. I don't know if if he's just really frustrated or... But a real kind of dark side seems to be coming out.
You know, I think that's got a lot to do with the female connection.
Right.
When someone's playing with your heart, I know you said you shouldn't cry for an MP and something, but if your wife
playing with your heart, he's only known her 5 minutes.
Surely.
Yeah.
They're in there 24/7 and they see each other the whole time. It's a more accelerated environment. Emotions are always heightened. We see them falling out.
He's basically fallen in with Marcus and Siavash, and there's like a little gang mentality. So that, you know, Siavash and Marcus, clearly the ringleaders, they're committing these criminal acts, and he's just being dragged along in their wake. You know, he can't help himself.
Do you feel he's been led astray by Marcus?
No, totally not. I mean, he's always been rebellious in the house. He chucked stuff in the swimming pool.
Ooh, big
when Noreen was sort of had the marker on, and he went solidarity, I'll wear a towel and things. That's just a streak within him.
He is a wild one, that boy. He's a wild one. Now B seems to have distanced herself.